Opposites do attract.
So let's talk about the science behind love. And is there any way that someone can find themselves a better partner?
Yes.
Yes.
We know so much more about the science of love than we did even 10 or 15 years ago. Mm-hmm. And in fact, I just wrote a book called Love Sense that talks about that and talks about it as a revolution. Mm-hmm. You know, we've had a revolution in parenting in the last 40 years from studying bonds and what happens between the bonds between mother and child. Mm-hmm. And now the same thing is happening. We're applying all that knowledge to the love between romantic partners. Mm. And so what we know, for example, is that when you fall in love, you are flooded with this cuddle hormone called oxytocin, mm-hmm. that is only happens in mammals who bond, who stay together, who protect, groom each other, and stay together for a long time and really rear very vulnerable young. Mm-hmm. So this is a very, it's almost like the chemistry of our brain developed so that we could survive and bond and take care of our young. Mm-hmm. So we know a lot about it. And we know now that the most important thing in love relationships is emotional responsiveness.
What do you mean by that?
What I mean is the most important question in love relationships is, are you there for me? Can I depend on you? Mm-hmm. Love is an ancient, wired-in survival code designed to keep the people you love close to you, mm-hmm. so you can depend on them. And it's wired into our brain that way. Mm. So are you there for me? Can I turn and get you to tune into me and respond to me? That's how we need to check out whether we found a mate or not.
And sex is an important part. Orgasm releases oxytocin,
yes,
as,
yes,
well.
That's right. Yeah.
And so that's like an extra burst that couples also need to take care of. So that cuddling time that comes with sexuality just reinforces the whole experience. And the couples who stay together and have the bond and encourage the emotional responsiveness and have a sexual relationship that is responsive and attuned to each other,
yes,
they're the ones who end up with synchrony sex, where they can actually read in each other the anticipation of the other person's emotional and sexual energy.
I think it is becoming a lot less of a mystery, and it's good that we have some science behind some of what we're doing, working with couples and, you know, helping them create that bond and keep that bond. And oxytocin is the same chemical that's released, you know, when we talk about mothers having babies, it's the same thing. And I think in men, they've identified vasopressin, and that comes from bonding and physical closeness and, mm-hmm. and that connectedness. So it could be physical, but it could also be your emotional expression and having someone responsive to you bring about these hormones as well.
I like to think about, like, in why do we get attracted to that particular person and not someone else? And a lot of people think it's just like mysterious, but it's actually not. I think there's an unconscious blueprint that attracts us towards certain partners and not others. Mm-hmm. And I think there's something very important about that, understanding that. I think we get attracted to people that for one side have something in common with us, so we have some common values. But at the other side, they have actually something different. There are different on certain aspects, and we get attracted to them because we want to attract something into our lives. Mm-hmm. So for example, if one person is more reliable and stable and logical, a lot of times they get attracted to someone who's kind of more passionate and emotional and spontaneous. It's because they feel that both of us together will be better than just each one of us separately. We want to bring something in. The problem also, though, is that the same differences can also cause you to later on to have conflict and arguments.
Right.
So you have to learn how to bring them in rather than make them an obstacle.
Right.
Opposites do attract, and they, you know, it's all those psychological, but it's also chemistry. And some of the studies suggest that it's our sense of smell. And since women tend to have a better sense of smell, it's actually women who are checking out the men before the men even know. And so that's a really important part of it, because it is a very, very physical experience for human beings. We need that connection, but we need it close and within our sphere and within our zone.
I agree with that. And you're going to meet who's around you. The person you're going to meet isn't going to be, they're not going to be far away. You're just never going to see them. And I think not assuming, well, that I just have chemistry with that person's my soulmate. I think you've got to, you know, peel back the layers to see, do you have the same value system, and is that person responsive to you? If that person that you just described doesn't respond when you do express your needs, hopefully that will signal to you that either there's a problem or time to move on to somebody else. Mm-hmm. Don't keep trying.
So it sounds like if someone's looking to find better love, there's a lot of chemical cocktail going on that's going to draw them to people. But if they want to pick a better partner, know thyself, keep their eyes open, pay attention to who's around them, know their values, and by all means, pay attention to who turns in and looks to you and is open to what you're looking for.
Yes.